Hello students, so welcome back to my channel. So in this video we are going to study about algae, and I'll be trying to give you the comparative study of all the three classes of algae. So algae is having three classes. One is your chlorophyce, which is also known as green algae. Phaeophyce, which is known as brown algae. And rhodophyce, which is known as red algae. Okay, so these are the three classes of algae, and now we will study a comparative account for it so that it will be very easy for you to study. Okay, now let us see the comparative account of all the three algae. First of all, we will study with respect to the habitat where they are found. So green algae is found in the fresh water as well as marine also, so fresh water plus marine, but mainly it is found in the fresh water. Okay, so you have to remember ki mainly it is found in the fresh water, and the marine, only in the marine we have studied only one example, that is Acetabularia. We have to learn only one example of marine algae, that is Acetabularia. Clear beta? Now for brown algae, only marine habitat, and for red algae also marine habitat, but here we will focus marine warm area. Okay, so this is the way first you have to learn with respect to the habitat, where they are found. Now the question area from this, if they ask you which algae is found in the tropical sea, the tropical means warm area, so your answer will be generally going with the red algae. And if they ask you which algae will be seen in the temperate sea, then your answer will go brown algae, because they are mentioning the sea word. Sea means marine habitat. Understood beta? Now we have to focus next topic with respect to the cell, thallus organization. Okay, now the second criteria we are taking, thallus organization. So in the thallus we are finding they are having unicellular form also. Unicellular form example is Chlamydomonas, which is motile. I'm writing in short here, motile. Chlorella example, which is non-motile. All the examples are of your NCERT, but they are not placed in the plant kingdom. This Chlorella example is given in the NCERT in your economic importance of algae, means above the green algae, one paragraph is there, you will find this example there. Okay, then colonial example, colonial form is your Volvox. This is your diagram based question. Then filamentous form, is your Spirogyra, NCERT example. Eulothrix, also NCERT example. Clear beta? So these are the few examples you have to remember for the green algae. Another example of the filamentous, these two are the examples which are unbranched. Here they are unbranched filament. And another with the branched filament is Scara, which is given in the 12th class book. You'll be studying this at the example in the 12th class. This is with the branched. So you may do one thing, you don't study it as a filament, you study it separately. This is also one important example of the green algae, Scara. So I think so up till here your thallus organization of Scara is clear. Now see the thallus organization for brown algae. First of all, in brown algae, unicellular forms are absent. Unicellular forms are absent. They don't have unicellular, it means they are having only giant forms are present. Giant forms are present, and these giant forms are known as kelp. You call this giant form as kelp. which can be simple branched to extensively branched also. To excess branching can be also there. Excessive branching. Clear, beta? And for this, thallus organization, they can be unicellular to multicellular. Two multicellular form can be there. Now let me give you the list of the example of brown and red or green already given to you. So these are the list of the examples of the green algae according to your NCERT. You have to learn all these examples. Okay, if you're preparing for the NEET. And here the list of the examples will be your Ectocarpus, Laminaria, Sargassum, Fucus, Dictyota. Clear, beta? And here your examples will be Porphyra, Polysiphonia, Gracilaria, and Galidium. So you have to learn the examples. These are only the examples of your NCERT. So this will help you to learn the topic very easily. Okay, where which example you have to study, please remember. Now next criteria we'll be taking with respect to the cell wall. Okay. Now see next criteria with respect to cell wall. So you are finding outer is pectin and inner is cellulose. Here if you see in the brown algae cell wall, outer is non-sulfated phycocolloid. Non-sulfated phycocolloid. And that non-sulfated phycocolloid is your alginic acid. Alginic acid. And inner will be cellulose. Now in case of the red algae cell wall, if you see here, outer will be sulfated phycocolloid. Please focus the difference. Outer is your sulfated phycocolloid. Which is your agar. Okay, beta, this is agar. It can be your carrageen also. And inner is your cellulose. So cell wall is clear. Now with respect to the pigment. Now let us see with respect to the pigment, which pigment is present. Pigment is here chlorophyll A and chlorophyll B. Here the pigment will be chlorophyll A and C, and it is predominance of fucoxanthin. Here the pigment will be chlorophyll A and D and R phycoerythrin. So once if you have learned this much, I hope you are finding your algae is coming into a grip. Okay, beta. Now next we'll be focusing with respect to the stored food. Here the stored food will be starch. Here also it will be laminaria and mannitol. And here it is Floridian starch. Clear, beta? Now let me explain you with respect to green algae. If they say ki they store food starch in the form of pyrenoid. Let me explain you. Now see class, in the case of green algae, let me draw the diagram. This is of the Chlamydomonas. Okay. This is a cell membrane and this is a cell wall, which is not true cellulosic. It is rich in hydroxyproline. And this is a chloroplast, cup-shaped chloroplast they are having it. So green algae shows variation in the chloroplast. Here in the center, we will draw this is nucleus. These are the two basal granules from where the flagella will arise. They are having two contractile vacuole. Okay, beta, I hope you are understanding everything. Let me do the labeling. This is contractile vacuole. This is nucleus. And this is the chloroplast. And now you have to focus the diagram very carefully. In the center of the chloroplast, you are finding this is pyrenoid, in which center is protein over which a starch is deposited. So this is pyrenoid. Let me draw the diagram outside. Center protein coat over which a starch is deposited. This is starch coating is going on. And this structure is known as pyrenoid. So if they ask the question, check carefully in the center, what do the pyrenoid has? In the center, this is protein. Okay, beta, once again, please learn it properly. Center, this is protein, and this is the starch sheet they are having it, over which the starch sheet is present, and this structure is present inside chloroplast. Now, last topic, what you should learn is with respect to the reproduction. Let me for reproduction, green algae will show isogamy. It can show isogamy, it can show anisogamy, and it can show oogamy also. Okay, isogamy means gametes will be of same size. Anisogamy means one gamete is bigger and second is small. Oogamy means one is stationary and only one is motile. Check the diagram. Through the diagram, you are able to understand that the green algae is having apically inserted flagella. Please learn it carefully. They are having apically inserted flagella. Clear? In case of brown algae also, it is having isogamy. It is having anisogamy. And it is having oogamy. Isogamy means it is having actually similar morphologically, but they are not having apically inserted flagella, they are having laterally inserted with unequal heterocont condition. This way, sorry, don't remember this way, just see here. Now you have to remember, please, that they are having the laterally inserted flagella. Here one is big in size and one is small. Oogamy this way. So I hope you are able to understand that in case of brown algae, the two flagellas are laterally inserted, and they are heterocont condition. In case of red algae, only oogamy, you have to remember that it is showing only oogamy. And in this case, non-motile male gamete, this is female gamete. And even male gamete is also non-motile. And this non-motile male gamete is known as spermatia. Non-motile male gamete is known as spermatia. So this is male gamete. I hope this comparison will help you to learn the algae topic very easily. In the next video, we'll be discussing about the bryophyte. Thanks for watching, class.